Thank you for joining us once again, guys. Welcome to my channel. My name is Ibukoluwa and I am the Nigerian movie critic. Okay, guys, today we're going to be looking at a movie. Can you guess? Love is War, guys. Love is War. Okay, this movie is a 2019 production written by Chinaza Onuzo and directed by Omoni Oboli. You know Omoni Oboli, right? Whatever she does is usually a success. But before we go into the deep details of this movie, let us check out the trailer. We'll be right back.
Mrs. Phillips, tell me, how does it feel to be the first female PPM gubernatorial candidate?
I know that I'm the best person for the role, irrespective of gender.
Good evening, Your Excellency.
Even better than your husband?
Advocate. I am the one that will lead you to your crown.
This is going to destroy us.
We are us. Nothing can destroy us.
Why are you running against each other?
Hey, 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 ask your father.
Kinimawi.
Welcome back from that awesome trailer. Trust me, this movie is quite a movie. I mean, you know, you don't always have to have complex storylines and complex plots before you have a good movie. This is a simple storyline, well executed, beautiful directing, great cinematography, awesome music, sound accompaniment, and all that. But let's take it one after the other, guys. First of all, we all know Omoni Oboli. She's a talented, super talented actress. She's a producer and she's also a filmmaker, okay? And she directed this movie. Not only that, guys, she is also the main character of this movie. I can imagine how she did that, directing at the same time being the main character of the movie. And trust me, she did an awesome job. So what is the story about? This is about a couple who, the wife is a known politician and she's about to contest for the governorship of Ondo State. Things were going fine for her, you know, and then suddenly the opposition party took up her husband to actually run against her. Fun, interesting, good, but then I'm left to think, how realistic is this? I mean, the plot is good, the storyline is good, but then in the Nigeria of today, how realistic to have a couple as opposing running mates for a governorship election? I'll leave you to decide that, guys. Okay, so they came together and decided that the husband should lose so that the wife would win because she felt she was the better candidate. So they agreed. And said, the husband said, okay, I would run and I would lose. I'll just make sure you win and all that stuff. And things were going so smooth for them. And then suddenly something happened one day. And the lady, the woman, the wife, that is Mrs. Ankuri Phillips, said something. And the husband got angry. And then he decided that he was going to take the election seriously and would no longer lose for her to win. Because according to him, he now felt he was a better candidate of both of them. So things changed.
I know you, Yuri. You went there hoping to use it against me. Otherwise, you would have let it go.
I went there to prove that I'm the better candidate.
So why did you do it? Why didn't you let my mistake go?
Why would I? The fact that you made that mistake proves that you're unfit. Are you so small that you couldn't live in my shadow for a little while?
A little while? Did you say a little while? Yuri, all I have done is live in your shadow. You will never know the sacrifices that I have made to allow you
to... allow, to...
You know what? I think we've reached the limit of this conversation.
Okay.
I'll wish you luck, but I will mean it.
Okay, guys, so aside the fact that I don't find the plots quite realistic, I mean, in Nigeria, same family, husband and wife contesting for the same election in the same state, even if you're contesting for the fun of it and you plan to let one person win and the other fail intentionally, it doesn't sound realistic to me. I mean, how would the public take it? Okay, one other thing I feel I really enjoyed about this movie is the theme of the movie. Now, this movie is centered around godfatherism in politics, power dynamics.
Don't thank me. Win. Just win.
But most importantly, the participation of women in Nigerian politics. I may not like the unrealistic aspect of the plot, but I like the fact that the ending was not that she stepped down for the husband to become governor. I liked the fact that they both decided to let her become the governor because she probably was the best candidate. She had what it takes to rule the state. And I am quite happy with the fact that it wasn't a case of, oh, support, calm down, you're the woman, go and support your husband, be a good wife kind of thing. So that was a good message for me. And secondly, I loved the first scene so much. The first scene opened with a beautiful speech coming from Omoni Oboli. She was addressing a particular group of people, telling them about her intentions towards politics, how she became minister in the first place. And I loved our lines. Our lines were insightful. They were eye-opening. They made us understand the importance of women participation in Nigerian politics. It was really wonderful. I really loved that scene. That for me is my favorite scene in the movie. Really beautiful scene and very insightful. Let's talk about actors. This movie consists of great actors. The likes of Shafi Bello, Omoni Oboli, the likes of, Akin Lewis, and just veterans. Veterans in the industry, and it was wonderful. Shafi Bello and Omoni Oboli, those women are wonderful actresses, and every time I see them in movies, I'm always motivated to want to see the movie. And they did an awesome job. Omoni Oboli has been known for several great movies, Figurine. She featured in Figurine, Moms at War, Women on Strike, and so many other movies like that. And Shafi Bello too is a very well-known, popular, great actress as well. Okay guys, let's move on to some of the things I do not like about the movie. First, Dimeji Phillips and Ankuri Phillips have a daughter. At the very first appearance of this daughter, I was confused. I didn't know she was their daughter. She sounded more like an elder sister to me. I couldn't really place her character. She was rude, she was bossy to even her parents, even to people who worked with her parents. There was a point where she insulted them and hissed and, you know, just went out. Just like that. So I feel that that character was not exactly well played. For a girl of 19 years, according to the movie, she's between 19 and 20. She was rude, she was disrespectful, and she was too bossy on her parents for that character. So I particularly did not like her character as a person. Okay guys, one more thing is that I do not like the fact that there was no background as to how Dimeji Phillips merged his political ambitions with his medical doctor job. I mean, he is a medical doctor. How they showed him in a scene where he was having a ward round and we knew how busy he was as a medical doctor. How did he combine his job and all the campaigns and everything he went for? There was no background information of that, and that for me was not realistic enough, guys. One more thing, guys, is the fact that this is a political movie. You would expect to see lots and lots of security personnel in campaigns and rallies and stuff. But there were many scenes where we saw no security personnel. For me, it made the campaign seem unrealistic. For somebody, we know how politics is in Nigeria. We know how campaigns and rallies are. But I only saw about two scenes out of like six or seven political rally scenes where they made use of security personnel. The only thing we had were people standing at their back wearing whatever clothes they chose for the rally. It wasn't realistic enough for me, and I felt they could have done more with security personnel in such scenes. It's a political movie. seeing security personnel is something we should be very used to. And it reminds me of the scene where Ankuri Phillips had a campaign and there was this suspenseful thing they tried to do with one guy coming out, trying to remove his phone. The audience would have thought he wanted to remove a gun, right? But then it was too close to go and snap a picture with an intending aspirant of governorship. That was unrealistic. A random person doesn't just go to snap with political, with aspirants of governorship elections. It wasn't realistic for me, guys, and I didn't really enjoy that part as well. So acting was good. It was good. I mean, those actors played their roles well enough. Aside the little things I believe the director or the cinematographer overlooked. Now let's talk about cinematography. The cinematography of this movie was wonderful. I mean, they had shots that were superb. There was this particular scene where Ankuri Phillips was talking with the character of Shafi Bello, and I didn't know the cinematographer took that shot from a mirror until he panned out and I was able to see that, oh wow, this is a reflective shot. It was awesome for me when I saw that. I really enjoyed that particular scene. So guys, in all, I think I would give this movie like a 50% thereabouts. It was good, but I did not find the plot realistic enough. The directing was great. The cinematography was on point. Acting was solid. The set design, I mean, I enjoyed the fact that in every campaign, they had a cloth. They had a uniform for each party. I mean, they spent a lot of money branding stickers and all that stuff to make it look absolutely realistic in that aspect. And I enjoyed that. So, guys, I would recommend this movie to be watched. I'm sure you would enjoy it. Let me know how you feel about this movie if you have seen it. And if you haven't, go see this movie and then you can join the conversation. Make sure whatever you have to say, put in the comment section below and let's get talking. Let's get the conversation going on the movie Love is War. Do not forget, guys, you have to subscribe to this channel. Click the subscribe button if you haven't done so. Tell your family and friends about this channel. Let them subscribe, let them like our videos, and expect many, many more exciting movie reviews to come. Based on your opinions and recommendations, I will be glad to do a movie review for you guys. So engage us, start your conversation on whichever movie you would like to see, and trust me, we would get right back to you. Thank you for joining us once again, guys. I would love to see you again in another episode. So I come your way again. My name is Ibukunlua and I am your Nigerian movie critic.